Jai Gurudev children, how are you all? Do you remember Asha? Yesterday you had learnt, right? How she helped her grandmother by picking the vegetables from the garden. You remember? Yes, you know, today she's really, really happy. Do you know why? Because she was able to help a farmer uncle. Do you all also want to know what she did? How she helped the farmer? Come, let's see then. Children, can you guess which plant is this? Did you get the name of the plant? I think this picture will help you better, isn't it? Did you observe? Yes, they are tomato plants. Can you observe here, children? Few tomatoes are red in color, few are green in color. Now the farmer was ready to pluck the red and juicy tomatoes. Come, let's see what he's going to do. The farmer plucked all the red and juicy tomatoes and put them in the basket. Can you see, children? There are so many tomatoes there. Now the farmer wanted to know how many total number of tomatoes he has plucked. He started to count and he was so confused as there were so many tomatoes in the big basket there. And he sat confused, thinking of what to do and how to count them. Asha was passing by and she saw farmer uncle a little unhappy. So she thought of asking him what had happened. So when she asked, farmer uncle told her that he has plucked so many tomatoes from the garden, but now he is not able to count and find out how many tomatoes are there. Then Asha remembers what she had learnt in her maths class and she thought of helping the farmer uncle. Asha took the tomatoes from the basket and started to keep one next to the other to make a group. Children, let's count and see how many tomatoes she kept in a group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So she took 10 tomatoes and made it into a group. Asha kept 10 tomatoes together, that is 10 ones, okay, which is equal to 1, 10, because in a group there are 10 tomatoes here. 10 ones is equal to 1, 10. Understood, children? In the same way, she kept on making a group of tens. Now, 1 ten plus 1 more 10 will be equal to how many tens, children? 2 tens or 20. When you count here, you can see there are total 20 tomatoes put together. She continued to add by adding groups of 10. She had put together two groups of 10s, which were 2 10s or 20. To this, she added another group of 10, that is 110. Now, children, tell me totally how many 10s are there? Look, there are 3 groups of 10s, that is 3 10s. Or when you count each tomato, you can see total there are 30 tomatoes or 30 ones. She had made 3 groups of 10s, that is 30 tomatoes. Now for this, she added another group of 10, that is 110. Now children, tell me total how many 10s will be there here? Tell me. Yes, there are 4 tens or 4 tens is equal to 40. Very good. Now, this is how she counted and told the farmer uncle that he had total 40 tomatoes in his basket. Farmer uncle was very happy and he thanked Asha. You know, Asha also was very happy because she was able to help uncle as she had learnt how to do counting by making group of tens. She had learnt it in her maths class. Children, now I know, even you know how to count by making group of tens, isn't it? See, like Asha, when we need to count a group of things, we can make it into smaller groups and then find out the total. Children, let's read the table and understand. 1 10 is 10 ones. 2 tens are 20 ones. 3 tens are 30 ones. 4 tens are 40 ones. 5 tens are 50 ones. 6 tens are 60 ones. 7 tens are 70 ones. 8 tens are 80 ones. 9 tens are 90 ones. 10 tens are 100 ones. Children, take out your Balganit book, turn to page number 31 and write today's date. Here you have to count it in tens and write the number name. Okay, we shall start with the exercise. First one is 110. So 110 is 10 and the number name of 10 is T-E-N, 10. It's already been given. We'll go to the second one. Here there are two bundles, that is two tens. Two tens is 20. We'll write the spelling of 20. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. In the next one, there are three bundles. If there are three bundles of 10, how many tens, children? Yes, it is three tens. So, three tens is 30. Let's write the spelling. T-H-I-R-T-Y, 30. Next, there are four bundles of 10, that is four tens. Four tens is 40. So, the spelling is F-O-R-T-Y. It is 40, children, not 40. We'll not write F-O-U-R, we'll write F-O-R-T-Y. In the next, there are five bundles of 10, that is five tens, which is 50. Even observe the spelling here, it is F-I-F-T-Y, it is 50. In the next, there are six bundles of tens, so it is 60. Let's write the spelling S-I-X-T-Y, 60. Now there are seven bundles of tens, which is 70. The spelling is S-E-V-E-N, T-Y, 70. 8 bundles of tens, which is 80. E-I-G-H-T-Y, 80. Then there are 9 bundles of tens, which is 9 tens, that is 90. N-I-N-E-T-Y, 90. Then we have 10 bundles of tens, so which is equal to 100. So let's write the spelling H-U-N-D-R-E-D, 100. Down you can see they have given the homework. Write the number names for all the tens in the notebook. So you can write the number names from 10 to 100, that is 10, 20, 30 up to 100 number names in your notebook and practice the spellings. Children, have you all done your homework? You are all now able to do the concept of zero. Very good. Pause the video and check for the answers, children. Children, this is a fun activity for you. You'll all have match boxes in your house, right? Ask your parents to take out the matchsticks and give it to you. Okay. Now I want you to make bundles to represent 4 tens and make bundles to represent 2 tens. Okay. Practice it. Children, I hope you enjoyed today's class. Keep practicing. Take care of yourself, children. See you in the next class. Jai Gurudev.